Hello everyone and welcome to my channel, Advice to Think Twice. My name is Monica and I'm here with our weekend advice for the weekend of the 3rd, 4th, and 5th of November 2017. Thank you for joining me. So we're going to go through the cards. I'm going to show you all of the cards and then tie the messages together as we do for the weekend reading. So we have number 1, Rainbow, connect to spirit and nature. We have Auburn, number 11, ground yourself. From the tarot, we have the 8 of Wands, the 5 of Swords is in the center of our reading, and the Ace of Wands. And then from the messages from your animal spirit guides oracle cards, we have Weasel, be silent, pay attention, and simply observe with your eyes, ears, and physical feelings what is happening inside you and all around you. And the Peacock, let yourself stand out and be noticed. So for this weekend, the message that I'm getting is about fresh starts and new opportunities, and the opportunity for us to take charge, for us to take a leadership role, for us to lead by example, for us to be the teachers, for us to be the voice of a group, and so on and so forth. Okay, it's about leadership and understanding when we need to step up and step forward, and when we need to wait and observe, gather more information before deciding how we want to handle a particular situation. We have, with the Five of Swords here, this is the more bold type of leadership, okay, like the Peacock. The Five of Swords tells us that sometimes we do need to stop questioning ourselves, and we need to not allow other people to question us, and to be the leader and rule with an iron fist. Sometimes that's what is required, okay? Not everyone's gonna like it, not everyone's gonna be our friend, but sometimes that is what needs to be done. And it could talk about situations where we've worked with people for a while and all of a sudden we got promoted and now we manage them. Now we're the team leader, now we're their boss. And it's a bit of a difficult, tricky situation because obviously, on the one hand, you still want to be their friend, but on the other hand, you're not part of the team the way that you used to be. Now you're the leader of the team, you're the manager, and whatever happens within the team or because of the team is reflected back onto you. And so that changes dynamics a little bit. So the Five of Swords tells us that through the changing circumstances, environments, and people in our lives, and our role and responsibility, there will be times when we're gonna have to take charge and not take no for an answer, really step up and kind of assert ourselves. And there will be other times when we will need to observe and gather more information, like the Weasel. Be a fly on the wall. Gather information also talks about listening to other people, observing what is going on for ourselves, doing our own research, getting more information within specific areas, situations, areas of study, anything like that, before deciding the best approach to a particular situation. And that's what the Weasel is. It may be that we are dealing with a lot of people during this time, and everyone just has different requests or expectations or responsibilities for us. And it may be that we feel slightly under pressure because of that with this Eight of Wands. The message is, do what you can. However, if someone's trying to be a bully, or if someone's trying to guilt us into doing anything, then with the Five of Swords, we're gonna have to clearly express ourselves. This is what I can do, this is what I will do for you, and this is what I cannot do for you. I'm sorry, you're gonna have to find someone else to do that for you. It's about clear communication. It's about being very clear, okay, so that everyone sees, everyone hears our message, everyone knows what we're trying to say. Okay, it's about being clear, clarity in communication, and being direct. We don't have to be rude, we don't have to be mean, but it's about being direct in our communications, especially when it comes to things or people or situations that we are responsible for, okay? Because this can be attached to a new job and, you know, not everyone's happy about it, but at the end of the day, you've earned it. You're there because you've earned it. So it's about not letting other people say things about you or push you into a corner or make you feel like you don't deserve that. Okay, it's first looking at the situation. How does everyone feel? What does everyone think? What's going on? Finding our own footing within the new circumstances. And once we have enough information, then we decide how we want to proceed. And then we're not afraid to stand out and express ourselves and assert ourselves. Okay? This could also be the case with something changing within our circle of friends, for example. Someone's having a bad time, someone's having a bad day, someone's having a rough situation, circumstances that they're dealing with, and they're taking it out on other people. The message is, in that case, you know, tensions may run high, it may be easy to snap at people, and if someone's having a rough time and they're taking it out on us, it may be easy for us to shout back at them. However, again, it's about observing what is going on, trying to understand what's behind a particular attitude or what's behind a particular behavior that is out of character for someone. And once we have enough information and we're happy that we understand what's going on, then we can lead by example. So maybe we can calm people down and ask for them to show forgiveness or to show compassion or to show patience, okay? Maybe we try to be the mediator within a difficult situation and resolve a difficult conflict perhaps, or arguments that are happening, okay? Because we pay attention, we wait, we listen, we observe, we try to come up with our own judgments and our own conclusions, and then we try to lead by example and to show others a better way of handling a difficult situation, so that instead of no one winning, which is the case when we get very sensitive and then defensive, we end up shouting at each other and talking at each other as opposed to trying to actually resolve the issue. And so it's about being a leader by example and diffusing difficult situations, because we will see behind the facade, we will see behind a particular behavior or a particular phrase that they say, or a particular attitude. We will see, we will look at it and think something doesn't feel right. Okay, even though it hurts my feelings, if it feels like there's more going on, so I'm gonna look deeper into things before I decide how I want to proceed. Okay, I'm gonna hold back. If I need to use that sword, I will, but for now I'm gonna hold back and get more information, talk to people, figure out what's going on, and then decide what the best way forward is. Okay, by observing as opposed to reacting, okay, before we know exactly what's going on, by taking our time to observe, to gather information, that's a way of grounding ourselves. When we focus on the information we receive through our senses, what we see, what we hear, how we feel, what we sense about a situation, that calming energy that even makes it possible for us to observe without getting emotionally triggered, that is a form of grounding ourselves. And it's important because sometimes we do need to be the stable person in the room. Sometimes we do need to be the calming influence within a room or a situation. And this is just a reminder of that, that sometimes we're going to be the leader by example. Even though we're not the boss, we can still diffuse a tense situation between the boss and our coworkers or our peers or whatever the case may be. Even though we're not the parent, we can still have a positive influence in a difficult or over a difficult relationship between our parent and our sibling. Okay? And so we are reminded to use our gifts, to use our compassion and our intuition, and to remember that we are strong, okay? And it's that inner strength, that quiet strength that maybe not a lot of people see, but they don't have to, okay? We don't have to show off to show people that we're strong. We can lead by example, which is a more graceful type of show of strength, if that makes sense. Okay. In a lot of ways, you know, this is about growing up and potentially helping others grow up in a sense. And by that, it could just mean showing them that there's a better way, showing them that there's a different perspective that they can use to look at a situation so that they see good as well as bad, okay? Not just the bad. They can see the good, they can see the possibilities, they can see the options, okay? This could also be happening the other way around, where we may be going through a rough time and not sure what to do, and there may be someone who seems to keep it together and seems to want to help and to seems to want to calm us down. And it's about, again, learning from that person or learning from what they're trying to do and then applying it for ourselves, because it's going to make the world of a difference. There may be some, there may be the possibility or the potential for some tense energies, and it could be because there's just a lot of people in the room, or it could be because there's a lot of opinions that we're dealing with, there's a lot of perspectives, there's a lot of attitudes that we're dealing with at one point or another during this time, and it could get complicated and blown out of proportion very, very quickly. You see, you have two fire cards talking about short fuses and hot tempers and how easily things can spiral out of control. And we have a swords card talking about staying calm, cool, collected, trying to use our rational mind to cool down this fire, okay? Which can be someone's temper or our own temper with this energy. If we ground ourselves, we have a much better chance of keeping it together and staying calm and being able to see behind a facade to see what the actual situation is, what the actual cause of something is, what the actual problem is. More often than not, it will be someone who's hurting and they don't know how to handle it, or they don't know how to express themselves, or they don't know how to ask for help. But if we stay grounded and we don't let our egos be triggered by anything that they may say in the heat of the moment, then we can see behind it. And then we can understand how to help them. Whether it's giving them information, calming them down, addressing whatever the issue is, or just trying to teach them how to calm down, or trying to help them relax by showing them how to breathe, how to calm down, how to focus on other things as well. So it's a reminder of the fact that strength doesn't have to be in your face, and strength doesn't have to be violently or loudly asserting ourselves. Quiet strength, subtle strength, graceful strength is where we lead by example, where we don't allow our egos to be triggered, where we see what's happening, we hear what that person's saying, and maybe they're saying something that hurts our feelings. We acknowledge the fact that they hurt our feelings, But we don't let that get the best of us and get us all worked up to the point where we feel like we just want to shout back at that person and we want to say things that hurt them in return. But rather, we observe, we take it all in. We try to figure out what's behind the issue. And if there's anything that we can do to help the situation, if there's anything that we can do to give it a different direction, or to give it a fresh start, or to heal it, to restore it, or if it's best to put our foot down and just walk away, not even get involved with that type of energy. Okay, it's going to be different things for everyone, but it's a reminder to stay grounded, to pay attention to our senses and what they tell us, and also our intuition, and then take charge within a situation. And that means decide how you want to approach it, decide if we have to speak up, or decide if we can lead by example, or decide if we want to get involved at all. Okay, but it's still seeing ourselves in as a deciding factor within that situation, because that means we don't allow ourselves to feel powerless or bullied or pressured or anything like that, or hurt. But rather, we see ourselves as, okay, well, I see that this is what's going on, but I get to choose how I want to react to this. I get to choose what I want to do about it. I get to choose if I let it get to me or not. I get to choose if I help this person figure out what's going on for themselves, or what the best approach is. Okay? The overall sense that I'm getting is that it may be up to us this weekend to, like I say, be the calm person in the room, be the light during dark times, or you know, where you deal with confusing times. And it may be up to us to teach people around us that there's a better way. There's always a better way to actually resolve issues, prevent issues, as opposed to just letting egos be triggered. Okay, so it's up to us to be the guide. It's up to us to be the teacher, the mentor, the sage, the wise person during this time. And that's because we can be the mentor and the guide and the teacher. And we're just reminded of our own strength. So it's a bit of a different message than we usually get, but I hope that it makes sense, and I hope that it helps if you're ever dealing with these energies. Let me know what the cards talk about for you. Let me know what they make you think of that you may be dealing with. I'm always looking forward to your comments. I'm doing my best to post the weeklies as soon as I possibly can. Other than that, thank you so much for all your support. I hope that we have a wonderful weekend, and I'll talk to you again very soon. Take care.